It's a bird. It's a plane. No way. It's the Blue Angels at the 1989 Naval Air Show. The Navy's top fighter pilots take to the air, and we take you right where the action is. You'll see unbelievable flying stunts. Not to mention, we have a special guest, video premieres, and more. And it's all only right here on Real Video.
Hi, and welcome. Welcome to Real Videos. Today, we are at the El Toro Marine Base, the United States Marine Corps Air Base, at their 1989 air show. And this is going to be one of the most exciting shows we've ever done. You know, we're so excited about today's show. We had to buy special shirts and everything with wings on them. And it's going to be fun, though.
Here's another boy show.
This isn't exactly, a female type show unless you're really into airplanes.
A lot of girls here, so that's nice. If your husband's into it,
it's on the show today, whether you like it or not. So if you don't like airplanes, go ahead and flip it. But today, we're standing right here behind a FA-18. It's fighter and attack airplane. It's an F-18. All sorts of airplanes. The highlight of the show today is what? What's going to be the highlight of the show?
I don't know. Airplanes?
No. Well, what's the most exciting thing about the airplanes today?
The airplanes? Yeah. The Blue Angels are here.
The Blue Angels. Today, the Blue Angels are going to be streaking through the sky. Right now, they've got all sorts of things going on. Back behind us, they've got biplanes. And just a minute ago, they had an F-14 Screaming Eagle flying around. And it was doing stalls and flips and turns and all sorts of... I've never been to an air show, so this is extra exciting for me. Today we have, of course, cameraman extraordinaire Paul Ripley. And you're about to trip over something. We're going to be doing all sorts of things today on the show. Let's go see some airplanes right now. Come on.
Yes, it does.
about air shows, I guess, is all the airplanes. Is there anything redeeming about them to you, Lovey?
It's pretty entertaining once they get up there and they're doing their flips and there's Ripley over there.
There's Paul. And, you know, one of the neat things is trying to keep track of your cameraman here. And today on the show, we're going to be doing all sorts of stuff. They've got food. They've got drinks. They've got all sorts of stuff.
The hamburgers smell great. They really do.
Now look at this airplane here. The little red thing sticking out in front there is the place where it gets refueled while it's flying along. It hangs on and gets fuel. In fact, let me ask this guy. Excuse me. We're doing a little bit of a television show. What's your name, first of all?
Captain Brian Beach.
Captain. What's this red thing right here for?
It's an air refueling probe.
Really? And what kind of aircraft is this right here?
It's an F-18.
Really? Now, do you fly this?
You bet.
Really? Now, what's it like when you're flipping and turning and all that kind of stuff? Are you going to be flying today?
No, I'm not. But, you know, when you get in a dynamic environment like that, you know, it's kind of just second nature, you know.
Really?
You know, it takes over. You know, I guess you do what you got to do.
Place where love will never cease. Willing to
today on Real Videos, you're going to be seeing a lot more than just airplanes and all that kind of stuff. You're going to be seeing the Blue Angels. You're going to be seeing all sorts of stuff. And I think the best way to start the show off would be to actually show what kind of guns and stuff they have on these airplanes. What are these here? Tim, do you know? Do you know what kind of bullets these are?
Those are big bullets, yeah.
these are big ones, and I'm thinking maybe these wouldn't be like the kind you use to deer hunt, that kind of thing. I don't know. This is a 50 caliber machine gun, Paul, and in case you didn't know that. But that's a guess. Maybe there's somebody out in the audience going, no, Matt, that's not a 50 caliber, but it is. So let's go this way. And this way, Paul. Come on, hon. You ever seen a 50 caliber machine gun before, dear?
Yes.
You have? Where?
Here.
Oh, South Central. South Central Los Angeles. There, look. Look at that. There's a guy out on the wing. Is there really? Are you serious? Go shoot it. Oh. Commander Duke Randy Cunningham. I can't believe it. Now this, of course, is a I've been stalling. The awkward moment of we were kind of pointing out dumb things is I was stalling because Commander Cunningham was in his trailer, and now this is going to be the most exciting part of the show today because this is the most decorated fighter pilot in the Vietnam era. Is that true?
Yes.
And this is the first all missile ace in the history of the United States Air Force and Marines and Navy. Navy, Air Force, all the same. And of course, the Tom Cruise and all of that movie was based on a lot of experiences that Randy Cunningham had. Now, you've flown all sorts of aircraft in your military career, and what is it really like to actually be flying them, doing these kind of stunts that we're seeing right now?
Well, this is a loop that he's going through right now. He'll go through a complete loop over the top. Now he's doing a roll. Now there's a guy on the top of this thing, which makes it even harder. He just did a half turn away. Looks like a Cuban 8 that he just did. I'm sorry, an Immelman. And he's rolling down out the area. The guy sitting on top, they're trying to hold positive G's. So if they put negative G's on that, it's going to pop him right off like you pop a bug off of a can. So the pilot is very important to the guy on top. And if he makes a big mistake, that guy's out of here.
Oh man, that is wild. I just want to celebrate another day of living. I just want to celebrate another day of love. Put my faith in the people, and the people let me down. So I turned the other cheek and I carried on anyhow. That's what I'm telling you. I just want to celebrate, yeah, yeah, another day of living, yeah. I just want to celebrate another day of love. Had my hand in the dollar. of people don't know that Duke Cunningham is an ace. Now, what does that mean for someone that doesn't know?
Well, you have to have 5 air-to-air victories. I've shot down 5 airplanes, and those airplanes were in Vietnam.
And you did it all with missiles from what type of aircraft?
From the F-4 Phantom, and they have some, we call them Smoke and Thunderhawks Phantoms. They have some flying in the show here. That was our primary fighter. Now, some guys that flew the F-8s in Vietnam would disagree with that. But I flew the Phantom, and all 5 of my air-to-air victories were with a Sidewinder, which is a heat-seeking missile.
You know, part of your story that a lot of people don't know, unless they've read your book, Fox 2, which, of course, I read. It took me about 20 minutes to read this book. As soon as I picked it up, I couldn't even set it down.
Oh, it's great.
But anyway, there's a part in this book about something real serious that happened to you on one of your missions there. And you took a little shrapnel from a SAM missile. And tell us about that.
Well, I was hit about 40 miles over North Vietnam. And when the missile ripped through the airplane, I didn't think there was much damage at first. So I just lit the burners and started heading toward the Gulf of Tonkin. Then all of a sudden, the hydraulics were going to zero and the airplane rolled upside down. And I can remember looking at the Red River Valley and thinking I was going to be a prisoner of war. Probably the most fear I've ever had in my life. You know, there's no white scarf and no Benson and Hedges hanging out your lips at that time, but you're pretty scared. And I remember thinking, and like a lot of people, the only time I'd ever ask for any divine help is when I was in trouble, okay? And I can remember thinking, I said, God, get me out of this. I don't want to be a prisoner of war. And I took the stick of the airplane and put it over to the left-hand side, and the airplane kind of righted itself. And I remember thinking, God didn't have anything to do with this. It was just my superior flying skills. And about that time, the airplane went back upside down. And I remember thinking, God, I didn't mean it. And I rolled the airplane out, and it finally exploded. But even more important than that is that I wasn't an atheist, but I couldn't say that I knew that there was a God. And coming down in a parachute, I made a vow to myself to find the answer to that, which I have done. And I think one of the biggest things in my life has been the finding of Jesus Christ.
Now, if somebody was watching you and heard that story, and there's a lot of people that are searching for something, we know that what they're searching for, everybody has a God-shaped hole inside of them that only He can fill. And it took you flying down in a after being shot down in Vietnam to really find that and really accept that. What would you say to somebody? How do they accept Jesus as their personal Savior?
Well, I think it's not easy in a lot of times, and you have to do a lot of searching, and you don't know what the answers are. And I know even today it's a constant struggle. You know, that devil's out there.
Yeah.
And for everybody, don't think that you're going to walk in, but all you have to do is, you know, close your eyes and invite Jesus into your heart, and He'll come. If you want it bad enough, just keep saying it, and it'll happen. And all you got to do is get on your knees and say a little prayer, and I guarantee it'll happen.
And that prayer is so simple to do. All you say is, Lord, come into my life. I accept you. And you don't have to wait to accept Jesus to where you're falling in a parachute, your F-4 Phantom has just been shot down, you're about to be a prisoner of war. You can do it sitting right there in your living room. All you got to do is say, Lord, come into my life. I accept you. And He'll be there. you have got to get it because it is the most radical war story and pictures. And there's one of my favorite things was just tell them real quick. Tell them about a lot of the things that happened to you in your life ended up on screen in probably the most popular war movie of all time. And that was, of course, Top Gun. And tell us about when you went inverted with your last victory in the air and when you went inverted and all that scene that ended up in the movie Top Gun. Tell us about that real quick.
Well, the MiG victories were choreographed in the movie Top Gun. Where I actually went upside down and communicated with a Russian was actually a Russian bear bomber in the Sea of Japan. I made a low pass by a tower and got in trouble for it when I was very young. So some of those kinds of things were taken after. Tom Cruise, Anthony Edwards, and Val Kilmer were very professional in the movie, and they're very fine young men. Tom works hard at what he does, and I have a lot of respect for him. He's done not only Top Gun, but you've recently seen him, he and Anthony and Val Kilmer in other movies. They represented, you know, the Navy guys, like they're flying out here, they knew what they did, but the American public didn't. And I think that for the first time, the public knew what they did.
Well, that was great. I'm going to tell a little story on him. The little scene in Top Gun where Tom Cruise was singing that was him. And of course, that was him kind of showing off back then in the old days. We appreciate you being on the show. And of course, you got my vote. Of course, if you're running for Congress in my area, then I'll vote for you and I'll tell everyone else to vote for you too. We're not supposed to do that on TBN, so take two. Well, we did it anyway.
I need to ask for letters. We've been slacking because we haven't hosted for a while, but please write me. I love your letters. Real Videos, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711. That's Real Videos, Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711. We need letters.
We do, and we'll see you next time. From somewhere not nearly as exciting as the El Toro Marine Air Show. But we'll see you next time on what show? What show is it?
Real Videos.
See, our real experienced cameraman, Paul Ripley, who hasn't run camera for us in a while, I said, Paul, be sure to get a lot of the real good excitement shots, you know. And he started rolling after the airplane had done this incredible maneuver and kind of had rolled over and done all this real neat stuff. Then he started. So basically all you saw of that was like after this real incredible move, then it just kind of leveled out, was flying like straight, you know, like airliners fly, you know, like 707s and stuff straight. So he really is a much better pilot than our cameraman, Paul Ripley, made him out to be, but he's good. His name's Bob Hoover, and he's flying this yellow airplane here and doing real neat things. But of course you haven't seen any of the real neat things because Paul wasn't rolling then. So maybe we can get some of the real good stuff later when we let T run camera. See, he's the assistant cameraman here. That's T. And maybe we ought to let him run first string camera instead of the seasoned pro Paul Ripley, who has to, like, we have to like adjust our shots to look he's well see you missed it again Paul you missed it again